how to use influencers to market your product. So it's become really popular right now. Everybody knows, man, if you want your product to sell, I mean, go and look for an influencer, look for a celebrity, look for someone with a large following, and let them display your product on their Instagram page. Does it really work? You need to check that. Does it really work? You see, when it comes to looking for influencers to market your product, you shouldn't be looking for someone with a large following. You should be looking for someone with a loyal following. It's the loyalty that sells, not the number of followers. Okay, so you see, you have someone with 2 million followers on Instagram, for example, and you have someone else with 2,000 followers. But then when both of them display the same product on their platforms, the guy with 2 million followers has no effect on the needle, you know, on your sales needle. It doesn't move it in any way. While the guy with 2,000 followers moves it. And then from him alone, you are getting like 200 orders. You see, what's the difference? The difference is that this guy with 2 million followers, his followers are probably not loyal to him. Because, I mean, think about it. They know that he was paid for that ad. They know. So they don't trust him. They don't believe, really, that product is going to help them solve the problem that he is saying is going to help them solve a problem. They don't believe. But they believe the guy with the 2,000 ads because he's their friend. Because they are loyal to him. Because they are connected to him emotionally. Now, I'm using 2,000 because even though it is small, it works. But sometimes it's 20,000 or 50,000 followers. That guy, they know him. They are connected to him or her. They are emotionally connected. They know they can trust this person. And then what even happens with the guy with 2 million followers, people with large following, is that they get so many products pushed to them for adverts so that on their page or on their platform, they always have these adverts there. So the people just look at them and they're like, oh, that's just another advert again, just like the last one. All right, let's move on to the next one. And so it doesn't work. They don't trust them. They know that they're getting paid. So if you see a page where the guy always has so many adverts, he's always pushing adverts on that page, please stay away. Why? Because their followers are used to getting products pushed in their faces. But if you see a page where it doesn't promote so many products, it just promotes a few products, it means that your product can stand out. There are not so many products being pushed into their faces. Your product can stand out. One other thing that you need to take note of is, what's the kind of followers that this person has? Understanding your target market, you should know that, oh, this person won't be, I mean, my target market won't trust this person so much or be following this person so much. This person probably amongst their followers, I don't have so many potential clients there. Okay, so for example now, you say, oh, this guy is a very popular musician. Let's have this popular musician push our product. I mean, he has millions of followers. So I'm sure that our product is going to sell. Man, we're going to blow up. Yes. But then your product is actually for women who have just given birth, for example. And then you're taking your product and then putting it in the hand of a musician whose followers are majorly kids. You know, secondary school, university children who just love the music and love to vibe to the music. It won't make it have any effect. But if you go to someone who has a few followers, but their followers have many women amongst them, their followers have many pregnant women or women who have just given birth amongst them, then that will have an effect. You get it right now. So you must understand, this person's followers, are they potential clients for me? Or does it just have a large following? But when I really look into it, my clients are not likely to be in it. There's a bank in Nigeria that, you know, employed a popular musician. I'm not going to mention the name of the bank, even though I know that you may already guess. Employed a popular musician to do their marketing for them. And then the moment they did it, I was wondering, like, really, are his followers, those who love him, are they the kind of people that the bank is trying to attract? Well, we don't know. Let's not talk about that, okay? So let's move on. All right. So check scriptures. Check all the disciples of Jesus Christ. Look at Peter, the guy who Jesus Christ put the assignment of spreading the gospel after his death on his neck. Peter, he said, feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. That's the guy who Jesus Christ used as an influential marketer of the gospel. And then you look at him. Why did he qualify for that? I mean, there was Matthew, the tax collector. I'm sure Matthew is more popular than a fisherman. A tax collector is more popular than a fisherman. He has a larger following than Peter. So why would Jesus Christ choose Peter? Look more deeply and you see that Peter has a more loyal following than Matthew. I mean, in John 21, after Jesus Christ was dead, Peter said, I go a fishing. All the other disciples were around Peter. Even James, even John, the beloved, was around Peter. And then he said, I'm going to fish. And they all said, we will go with you. His followers were loyal to him. Matthew had more followers. He was more popular. But his own followers were not so loyal to him. So you should be looking for that guy whose followers are loyal to him. That Instagram celebrity, so to say, whose followers are loyal to them. And then when you find that person, make sure that you give that person a cut, all right, of whatever it is that they sell. So they have their own unique link to your store. And then they get a commission on whatever it is they sell. That will push them to sell even more frequently than you can pay them to sell if it was just a one-off payment. So once they have a commission for it, they know that it's now their product, no longer just your product. And so they keep pushing sales onto your platform. But I'm looking for a celebrity with a loyal following. Someone who people love. Someone who people are attached to emotionally. That's the kind of person that can really help you sell your product. So someone could have 2 million followers. Someone else has 2,000 followers. And then when you use the guy with 2,000 followers, you make more sales than the guy with 2 million followers. Why? Because the guy with 2 million followers even has so many products. Now that's one thing to take note of too. If someone has so many products coming to them, so many products, and then they are always displaying products on their social media handle, don't use that influencer. Because their followers are now used to the fact that this person gets paid to push products in our faces. Not really that this product is good, this product is fantastic, but that he gets paid to push products in our faces, so he was just being paid for this new one again. And so, yeah, let's just move on to the next one. But if it's someone that does not always have products on their platform, that's someone to use, because then you can stand out. You can stand out. It's not so many products on the platform. All right. So that's someone to use. Now, if you are an influencer, this is how you market people's products. You don't go around saying, oh, you need to use this product. It's the best product. No. You use it. Then you tell people, man, I found a product that I think that you should use. Or you just on your normal day and say, man, this is what helps me do this. If you want it, click the link in my bio. Or if you want it, go to this website, go to their page. You just talk about what it helps you do. Okay? Just talk about, because your people are loyal to you, because they love you, because they admire you. So they look at you and say, oh, so this is what you use to look like this. This is what you use to do this. Oh, so I would like to use it too. Alright? So you don't just come and say, oh, this is the best product in the market when it comes to this. This is the best product. No. You tell them, this is what it does for me. And I think it can do the same for you too. So going back to Peter and Matthew, Peter was known to be a guy who was going to be a fisher of men. But what was Matthew's on? Why would the people want to do what Matthew does? This is a guy that just collects tax, or used to collect tax before he started following Jesus. And after he started following Jesus, we don't know the effects of being with Jesus on him. But we've seen it in Peter. We've seen him move from fishing, from looking for fish and, you know, failing in that, to now being a man that can speak, and then people are saying, this guy is speaking like a learned man. We've seen that effect. So it's someone like that that can tell people, come and meet Jesus Christ, because you can see the effect in me. So as an influencer, you should be telling them, see the effect in me. That's what's going to make them want to now buy that product. One day I'm going to talk, no, it's not for this platform. I want to tell you about how to build a team. How to build a team in your business. Jesus Christ built a team, his disciples, his 12 disciples, and each one of them had a role. Each one of them had an assignment to do on his team when it came to what he was to do. So we had Andrew, we had Peter, we had John, we had James, we had even Judas Iscariot. Every single one of them had something to contribute to the team. But that's not for this platform. That's for the Biblical Billionaire Club. So if you want to be part of the Biblical Billionaire Club, get to know some really deep stuff. Like how to build a team, for example, how to choose influential marketers, for example, and you want one-on-one coaching from me, you can click the link in the description down there for you to become a part of the Biblical Billionaire Club. It's absolutely free of charge, so you have nothing to lose. Just click the link in the description and it's going to take you into the Biblical Billionaire Club. My name is Femi Adesam, the Biblical Billionaire, and I'll see you in the next video.